This is Team Vesper. I am here to introduce you guys to our new project. But at first, I want to start off with a small story. A few days back, I was on my car working on my laptop, riding to my home, and suddenly a boy caught my sight. According to his appearance, he looked smart and educated, but unfortunately, I noticed that he had no hands. It is a pretty pity that a boy like him is physically impaired. I was minding on my own business, but suddenly a thought crossed my mind. How a person like him will use a computer? How his life might be without all those latest technologies of today? So I shared this idea with all my friends, and we started to work on our new project, which is named iPointer. You might have noticed that generation to generation, people are using all those traditional input devices to communicate with a computer. But we are introducing an advanced and modern technology to communicate with a computer. So we believe that this will create a new era of computing.
Eye pointer. The name suggests two different terms about eye and pointer. Eye represents human eye and pointer represents mouse pointer. Our main motive is to reduce the dependency on mouse and keyboard, whether we are using only a webcam and a microphone. Webcam is used for taking video inputs and microphone is for voice commands. Our main system is designed into three modes. We are calling these modes as cursor control mode, multimode and security mode. Cursor control mode replaces the mouse functionalities. Again, we can click, double click, right click with voice commands as well as eye blinks. Again, we have multimode. In this mode, we can scroll, fast forward, reward with head gestures. Again, we have security mode. This mode ensures the PC security from unauthorized access. Now guys, let's check the system.
Hello everyone, this is the interface of our system iPointer. Here we can see three different icons of three different modes, and this blue line indicates in which mode we are in, or the mode which is activated. So this box displays the voice input commands, and this box shows the cursor coordinates. And here we have two options, blink control and eye control. Let's check the eye control option. Move mouse cursor. Hide the application. We can do single click, right click and click in this mode. Let's have a try. Click, single click, right click, hide the application, move mouse cursor. Right click, single click. Click, go back. We can also perform the click option by eye blink. Activate blink control. Now we will explore some features of multimode. Here we have used head gestures and voice commands. Activate multimode.
Multimode activated.
Move mouse cursor. Enter. Upper stroke. Upper stroke. Lower stroke. Lower stroke. Next frame. Next frame. Previous frame. Previous frame. Zoom in. Zoom in. Zoom out. Zoom out. Move mouse cursor. Picture view.
Picture view activated.
Move mouse cursor. slide. The security mode of our system. For activating this mode, the user has to give a voice password within 5 seconds. After activating this mode, the system will create a trap. Then if anyone tries to access the system, an image of the person will be taken by the webcam and will be forwarded to the server. And also, a SMS will be generated by the system to the user mobile phone. Here in the security panel, we can see the image and also the date and time. Here, this is the phone number of the user.
Now, I will demonstrate the special feature of our system, the security mode. For this, we have developed a mobile app that will work as a remote to ensure the protection of your computer. Now, this app has several features. First of all, you can lock or shut down your computer anytime using your mobile phone. You can do this from anywhere in the world. Also, you can watch the video stream from your webcam to see who is in front of your PC. Also, there is a screen streaming option where you can watch what's going on in your monitor. After receiving the SMS message, we will have to open the app. And after opening the app, we can see the interface. There, we can click Show Uploaded Photos. Now, you can see the list of images that were uploaded in the server. And each picture contains the time and date when the person tried to access the computer. And now, we'll tap one of them. And we can see the person who tried to access the computer. Now, if we press the Take Action, we can go to the main screen and we can either lock or shut down the computer. Now, if we click Show Video Stream, on the upper screen you can see who is sitting in front of your computer, and in the bottom you can see what's going on with the monitor. So if we double tap one of them, now we can see the streaming enlarged and properly. Now we will take the appropriate action. I tap lock screen, and then I tap apply action, and we can see the computer is locked. Keeping the disabled people in our mind, we also designed this app to take voice commands. Shut down. Thank you all for being with us throughout this video. Hopefully, our project iPointer will bring a new remark on disability.
Move mouse cursor. Click. Go back.